Okay. First of all, I would like to introduce you to our department, right? Computer Engineering International Program, right? And my name is Natasha. You have already known. Okay. This is the new curriculum, right? We start this curriculum since last year, right? 2021st, okay? Last year, right? So you are senior, right? The second batch, the second years will firstly study this curriculum, right? And this curriculum will follow both TQF, right? Thailand qualification, right? And the KMUTT student qualification as well, right? And these are the features or the features for the KMUTT student. When you graduated from this university, you will have like a KMUTT citizenship, right? Responsibility, adaptability, humanization. Also, you have to get knowledge, the professional skill, your thinking skill, learning skill, management skill, communication skill, leadership, right? This is all things that is the common KMUTT students we have, right? And our curriculum, our new curriculum for the international program will follow this qualification, okay? I would say that if you talk to the regular or Thai program students, right, you can I would say that the program will be slightly different, right? For our international program, we will concentrate on the like data science, data analytic, and also we'll go through the like a business and the entrepreneurship, right? So so you can see many there are some many different courses that will difference from the regular program and international program, and this will be the program learning outcomes, right? That if you are graduated from the CPE, right, international program, all of you, it can be guaranteed that all of you will have this 5 PLOs, right? Starting from the first one, PLO 1 is the design and create the computer-based system by integrating and associating computer engineering knowledge, right? So you can, this is the first PLO will be about knowledge. And the second PLO will be about the skills, right? So if you are graduated from this program, right, you can be able to manage or manipulate computer engineering tools. You can use the tools. You can use many kinds of the editors or the programming languages that you can solve the problem or the computational problems. And also you gain the skills for analysis, problem solving, and also decision making. So this is about the skill, right? And the second one, and the third one is about the ethics, the professional ethics, right? The principle of health, morality, and many things that you have to be responsible and considerate of the whole impact of community, public, and environment. Okay, this is the, maybe it's not about the knowledge or the computer skills, but you need to be a good person in your community, right? But after your graduation. And the fourth one is about the communication. So because you are studying in the international program, right? So what you have to gain the knowledge, or you have to be practiced, right? You need to know how to present, to write a report in English, of course, with the knowledge and understanding for the listeners or reader in native English speaker effectively. This is the communication part is also the most important that you have to gain after graduation. And the last one, which is also important, because in Thailand or even for the Southeast Asian community countries, we also focus now on the lifelong learning and also sustainability, right? So in this program, right, it will provide you to have some kinds of the practice about leadership, followers, management, many things, right? And you also have to work in group, right? So you can have the chance or the opportunity to talk to your friends as a leadership role or the follower roles, right? That is very important for your future careers, okay? And the most important thing is that you have to be positive, right? Your attitude has to be positive in the working in your professional field. That is the main program learning outcomes that you may have to follow. And it's also delivered in many courses in this curriculum, okay? So you may have to, wondering about the details about each PLO, right? So maybe I will let you try to read, right? Because for each main PLO, right, we also have the sub PLO that you can understand that, and it can guarantee that you will know all after you finish these programs. Okay, this is 5 programming outcomes, right? And also this will be aligned to the KMUTT student QF and also the KMUTT QF as well. When I map the KMUTT student QF, right, with the all PLO here, you can see that they also match to and align with the KMUTT QF. Okay. And this one will be the structure of the courses that you have to study in this program, right? Starting from the first year, right, you can see from the below here, right? You can see that the class that you will have to study in this class will be starting from the computer programming for engineers, right? Discrete mathematics, right, that you will study on Friday. Engineering exploration, UX UI on Wednesday, I don't know. And also mathematics is about the calculus 1. And the red dot here is about the language, right? The language, okay? You can see that there are some differences between the international program and the regular program, because the regular program, they will study physics for the first term. But based on my experience, right, because the students, I don't know, if you have asked your seniors, right, you will know that in the past, our program, the percentage of the drop off or fail out was very high, right? 25%, right? And after I changed the order of the courses like this, I shift physics to the second term, right? You can ask your senior, right? It would be the percent of drop off for the student is lower, much lower. Okay, and then I put the UX UI, right? UX UI will be the course that is not available for the regular program, right? Only for the privilege for the international program. Okay, there is a question from Jarukit with, okay, what is the question?
Okay, I'm just confused that maybe are there any slides or presentation? Because like the screen sharing is stuck at the first page. I'm not sure.
Larry, the screen is...
Yeah. Yes. It's stuck on the orange page that say, yeah.
Only the first page, right?
Yes.
Can. Oh, sorry. Can you see the screen sharing?
Yes, I can see now. Thank you.
Sorry for that. I didn't recognize that. I just talked without changing Yes. Okay, if there is any troubles or any problems, please feel free to react to me immediately, okay? Sorry for that. And you asked for the slide, right? I have already submitted into the LINE group. Have you seen that?
Yes, yes.
Resume share. Can you now also see the... I'm changing the slide. Have you seen that?
Pay attention.
It's changing,
right? You can see it's changing. So
I can. I think I can see it changing.
Okay, now I'm at the page of the program learning outcomes. Can you see that?
It's stuck on the something like mind map or the chart or something.
Oh, yeah. What's happened? Sorry.
I think maybe you can use like this keynote program. You just don't present it and then you can slide. So okay. If you, yeah, I think it.
This one is better, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, sorry for that. Okay, so we are in this page, right?
Yes.
Okay, for the first semester, right, you will have 6 courses, programming. Programming, computer programming for engineering, CVE 100, that is the course that I'm teaching to you now. And we also have the discrete mathematics, engineering exploration, UX UI, and calculus 1, right? And also this one is the red one is a language, right? It depends upon your level of your English, right? So you can see that in our program, we will have the track, right? The blue one here, the light blue, is about the software track, right? So you have to study these 6 main courses, right? 6 main courses, right? Always we can say compulsory courses, right? Starting from programming, data structure, and algorithm. And this will be in the sequence. So if you cannot pass this course, so it is not allowed for you to study data structure. So this course is quite important. You all have to pass this. Otherwise, you will have to study programming again. You can study programming again in the second year instead of algorithm design. And you will be slower than your friends, right? Because you may have to the next term, you will study data structure, right? And if you cannot pass data structure, you cannot study algorithm design. So you have to, you may have to work hard, right, in order to pass the programming. And I think it's not that difficult. And also the important class will be this key in math as well, because for the algorithm design, right, the prerequisites for this course will be program, will be discrete math and data structure. If you cannot pass these two, right, I mean, if you got F, right, you cannot study algorithm design. But if you got D, both D, you can still study algorithm. Okay. And we also have the green track. The green track is about the data model and big data, right? In this international program, right, we will focus on this track as well, the data scientist, right, the big data. Okay, this is also the intense fields in the computer as well, right? If you want to do the machine learning, if you want to do AI, if you want to use some big data in order to formulate your model, in order to maybe to let your system can think or can be like evaluate like AI, right? You may have to study in this track as well. Okay, that is the main or the the strength of our international program. And you can see the red, the dark red here is about the hardware track, right? You start from the engineering exploration and then circuit design, digital and logic design, and then computer architecture, operating system, and the network, right? So you will have to, okay, you can see this here very clear, right, about the track in our program. And also, we also have the track for the mathematics, science, and language, right? So you may have to follow that. This is a roughly idea about our curriculum. And in the fourth year, right, you will, okay, this is also the privilege for the international program, right? You can also have the internship plus work integrated learning or VIL, right? In the fourth year, right, you are allowed to select a company that you would like to work with. For example, if you want to know about the system of the Wong Nai, right, or the Lai Man, right? Last year, I also have the student who have a VIL or work integrated learning with the Lai Man company, right? So you can go and have the internship there. And if you think you like this company and you would like to continue study and working there, so you can have some kinds of the, you can just, you don't have to, you may just enroll only one or two courses in the university, and then for 2 or 3 days you can work in a company outside the university. So that is possible for our programs. Okay, that's very nice, right? Because we have two tracks, right? The first track is VIL, and the second one is a senior project. Normally, if you would like to be graduated from this program, you need to finish, you have to work with your advisor, and with a project, senior project. You can work, it will be in group of two or in group of three. And if you don't want to work as the senior project, you may use VIL. You can select VIL that you will work with the company. Okay, up to now, do you have any question about our curriculum here? Okay, maybe now it's still new to you, right? But if you have any questions, you can ask me later on, okay? But this is the things that I would like to show you. And also, when we talk about internship, right, we also have the collaboration with many universities in Europe, right? For example, Finland, French, France, Germany, Switzerland, right? So you can go there, and there's some scholarship from the university, from the department, but not full scholarship, right? If you want to go and have an internship in the foreign countries, you may have your own budgets, and you can also have some budgets from the department. That is possible. Okay, this is the curriculum here. Okay. Up to now, do you have any question?
I have some question. Is it possible for us to have an internship in the first year or second year or third years before the course?
Formally from the department, because if you want to go formally, if you want to get the formal letter from the department, it has to be, you have to go for the internship after the third year. Mm-hmm. But if you want, maybe you want to go to USA for work and travel for the first year or second year, it's up to you, right? But that will not count it in your internship.
Oh, okay.
Your internship program will be after your third year. The summer of your third year. Mm-hmm. Because by that time you are good enough to work in a company. Thank you for your question. Wow, now it's 11. Seems like I talk a lot. Okay. Oh, sorry, I didn't change this one into translate into English, right? But we also have the year LO as well, right? But at the end of each year, I have some kinds of the assessment or evaluation, right? In order to guarantee that you all can, okay, are ready to go for the next year, right? Okay. Okay, I think that's all enough for the orientation about our international program, right? Okay. Okay, now, only because it's 1 hour already, so we will have a short break for 5 minutes, so you can go to have some fresh water or you go to the toilet, and then we will come back and start the first chapter. Okay. Oh, actually we start from 10:30, right? I'm sorry.
Yes.
I forget that. Okay, up to now, do you have any questions?
Excuse me, Professor.
Yes.
May I know where to check elective course for 4 years?
Elective course. You can also start select your elective course when you are in the second year, second term of the third year.
May I know where to check?
To check for the elective courses, right?
Yeah.
In the curriculum.
Yeah.
Go to the university. Do you have the curriculum?
No, I would like to know about the curriculum of elective courses.
Okay. I will give you in the line group, okay?
Yes, thank you so much.
Okay. Or if you can find it in the university website.
Mm-hmm. Sorry.
This, yeah, I would try. No need to say sorry if you want to get anything. As I just told you, right? If I can find it for you, I will give to you. But many important things, or even for this the curriculum, right? You can find in the department website. You can go to cbe.kmutt.ac.th, and then go to the international program, and then you can see the curriculum. Okay. Before I will go. The next important thing is that you have to, can you access to LEB2? เอาเงียบเลย รู้จัก LEB2 ไหม? Do you know LEB2?
คืออะไรครับ?
Okay, this is a learning environment, right? You need to know how to go. Do you know how to access to the student info? Okay, I will share this screen. Can you see this screen?
Yeah, yes.
Okay, maybe you have to go to LE. Wait. LEB2.kmutt.ac.th. LEB2. Learning environment, B2 means the second version or something. Okay, you can access to this. Okay, and then เข้าสู่ระบบ Why is in Thai? Okay, you can change to English. Okay, you can log in here. Oops. You have to access with your university username and password. Okay, and then you can come to this screen, right? This is my screen because I'm the lecturer here, right? So my name is here. And for you, I think your name will be appeared here as well. And from this one, you can see, okay, because I'm a lecturer, right? I can see two sections. because we have even we have one course here, right? But there are two rooms, section 31 and section 32, right? We are teaching at the same time for the lecture, right? That is on Monday morning. Okay, so but after this I will combine them together. So later on. So but now you can see two different sections here. If you have two different sections, right? You cannot make a group from different rooms. You can see that for section 32, right? How many members here? Okay, 38 members, right? Until 34440, right? Okay, so this is the first, the room A, and also we have the room B, right? So when if you can come to this LEB2, right, you can go to plan, right? And I will, for example, this is the first week, right? So this one you can go to syllabus. From the syllabus, you can see the course description both in Thai and English, right? And also I will provide you the learning outcome for this course, right? CLO, right? And then I'm the teaching team, right? I have not yet included the TA, right, to you, right? And also this is the first week, right? And you can see the learning activity here, right? Introduction to C programming. So you can click it. And then there is a list of the two files. The first one is the lecture note, right, for this today's class. And then we also have the syllabus for this class as well. I provide you just only two PDF files, right? And other on I gave you in the like group. Okay, so okay, this doesn't matter. I will provide you all later here, but right after when I combine these two courses together, right? Because these are separated. Okay, there is a question. Are all other classes, every class going to use? Okay, right. Every class for the learning materials, I will provide them in this LEB2, right? But because today is the first class, right? So maybe you are not familiar with the LEB2 or you don't know LEB2 before. So I just give you the example how to access to this, right? So in this week, I suggest you to go to the computer center to get the username and password, right, for yourself, right? I don't know whether you all have the username and password. Anyone in this room who still don't have the username and password, please press 1. Please press 1 into the chat room. Oh, okay, that's good. You all have the username and password. That's right. That's good. And can you access to the anyone in this room cannot access to LEB2 at the moment. ไม่มีใช่ไหมทุกคนเข้าได้หมดเนอะเออพี่ๆคงบอกไว้แล้วเนอะแต่พี่ๆคงให้ไว้แล้วใช่ไหมคะสอนไว้แล้ว Okay, that's good. So all of you can access to the system. Okay. And the question is, do we have to use LEB2 every week? That's of course, because if I ask you to submit some assignment or report, or even for the group report, you have to submit to this LEB2. So let me let you have a look into this one, right? When you go to syllabus, right, you can see the syllabus of this course, and then you can see the learning activity here, right? Normally, if I ask you to have the assignment, I will give the assignment here, right, into the access main activity. Okay, and then there will be the some deadline or the due date as well provided in the activity like this. Okay, so you have to check for it. Mm-hmm. But now, because it's all new to you, right? And many of you, or almost all of you, don't know about the LEB2 system. So that's why I asked you to add yourself to like group, right? How many people in the like group? Now 77. Now 77 students, we still have two people left who has not yet added into the like group. Okay, no problem. Any one of you in this room has not yet joined the like group? # CPE 36 CPE 100. Okay. All of you join this group, right? Have you joined this group? Okay. Up to now, do you have any question about LEB2? As I told you, right, I will have to combine these two sections in together first. You may have a question, why don't I join them now? Because my priority or my role cannot join them by myself. So I have to ask the administrator for the LEB2 system to join them for me, right? Otherwise, some of you from different sections cannot work together. Mm-hmm. ถ้าครูไม่จอยมันก่อนเดี๋ยวเวลาให้ทำงานกลุ่มแล้วเดี๋ยวบางทีคุณอยากจะจากเซกชันนี้ไปจับคู่กับเซกชันนั้นเดี๋ยวจะทำไม่ได้นะคะโอเค if you don't have any questions shall we continue with the next one I will have to introduce you about this course okay so then I will stop share here and then I willShare new screen with the, okay, this one. Can you see this slide?
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, so the next thing that I will talk to you maybe from 10 minutes here. That is how we introduce you this course. Okay. So I will start from the course syllabus, right? Okay. This is the general information about this course, right? My name, right? And my office room, right? This is in a computer engineer floor 10, right? And this is my private phone number, right? Just in case you can call me. And we also have, you can also have my line ID, right? So you can also call me from that as well. Okay. So you can see that my phone number is very nice and easy to remember, right? Just in case, right, you are in troubles, right? You can call me, right? For example, if you lost your mobile phone, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, and this one is an email, my email, right? Normally, I will access to my email frequently as well, mm-hmm. But I like to communicate in line. Mm-hmm. And teaching assistant will be Pitam, right? He's going to be the graduate student next term or this term, right? Mm-hmm. And for the lecture time, right? Now, today, Monday, right? From 10:30 to 12:30, I will give you the lecture about the computer programming, and then it will be online, mm-hmm. Because of the pandemic situation. Right, COVID pandemic situation. I will still have to give the lecture online first. But for the lab, right, we will see each other on Friday, right? And the Friday lab will be separated into two rooms, right? As I told you, section 31 will start from 1:30 to 2:20, and section B, right, or section 32, it will start from 3:30 to 5:20, right? That will be on site, right, in the computer room. So we will see each other in person there. But unfortunately, this coming Friday is the 12th August. It is Queen's birthday. So I don't know how to say King's mom birthday. Okay. So there is no class, right? So don't go to the university. It is a public holiday, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. And also this is a Zoom meeting, so you know already. Mm-hmm. This is the course description for this course, right? It will start from the fundamental concept of programming, starting from the variables, declaration, data type, conditional statement or branching, iteration, functions, I/O, and programming exercise, right? With programming exercise. And then you have to try to write the program into the software, right? And develop your problem-solving activities. And you need to also write a program with the robustness and correctness, right? So you have to the chance to debug your own program, and then you try to solve the problem by yourself. And we also have the weekly laboratory session, right, on Friday, right, that you can design and implement your program by yourself. I would say that this course is about programming. Programming means the skill. What does it mean by skill? It is the knowledge, right? Skill, you need to practice and practice many times. Even you have already finished one program, right? Sometimes you need to come back and then rewrite it again and again, like playing sports, right? Programming is like playing sports. You need to practice every day. So this is important. And then I will give you not only weekly laboratories, I will also give you the maybe to submit the programs, right? Maybe 2 or 3 days, right? Every 2 or 3 days, okay? That would be my idea of this course. And this also the course objective, right? You need to use the C language in order to create your program, right? Your programming, practice your programming skill, right? And you need to know the concept and practice of programming, right? In this course, we use C language. And I will tell you that what is the advantages of this using C languages. In this room, right, who has already studied a C programming language before, please press 1. Please press 1 in the chat box, right, so I can count how many people who have already, who have known some basic idea of the C programming. Oh, that's good. We have 30, 31, 32 students. Okay, it seems like there are about 34 students in this room who has some experiences about C programming, okay? But about the others, right? If you don't have any idea or you have no experiences about computer programming, so that would be fine. I will start from scratch, and then we'll go step by step together. But the most important thing is that if you don't have, you know that you don't have any experiences about programming, you need to work hard, because there are many students in this room who are very good in programming already. So you need to catch up or to run, right, in order to understand this quickly. But if you think you need my special help, for example, the one who have never studied programming before, okay, you have to let me know, okay? And at the end of the course, right, each student should be able to analyze a program, decide solution for this program in abstract form, such as pseudocode or flowchart, right? And also you have to code in C programming as well. Besides of that, you may have to, you can test or debug the solution, and then you can have to change, modifying the solution or the program. Mm-hmm. This is a skill, right? You don't only know the knowledge of C programming, but also you need to know how to debug and solve the, when you found some, how can I say, some problems in your programs. And this, the last one is that this will be the first course that will lead to the how to know the software engineering life cycle, right? So you need to understand this starting from the very basic foundation of programming, right? So in this program, you need to know how to work in group, and then you need to know how to write program in many modules, and then you can combine the modules all together to get the full function software, right? This is the course objective of this CPE 100. Okay, so for, if you want to know the learning outcomes of this course, right? How can I say? Normally you are not familiar with the word learning outcome, right? Normally when you were in high school, right? You know, you have known about the concepts of the course topics, right? Or course objectives, right? And then you can just study following the course objectives and course topics, that's all. That is the old style education. I would say old style of the education that the teacher will give you a lecture, and this one is a passive, right? You can just gain the knowledge from your teacher. But in KMUTT, right, Kim Mong Kun University of Technology, because it is a technology, and also Thonburi, and also it is a engineering education. So what you have to know, that is our new pedagogy, a new education, new style of education. So we have to focus on what you gain, knowledge you gain, the skill you gain. Okay, once again, in the past, if you want to get your grade, right, you can just show the teacher that you gain the knowledge. But in KMUTT, right, especially in CPE, in this curricula, you need to show me that you have the competency or the competence in C programming. So this is what I call learning outcomes and the course learning outcome, right? So that's very simple, right? You can be able to, after complete this course, you can be able to design, write, and debug program in C. That solve the problem following your detailed problem specification. This is the first one, the first learning outcome you have to do. And the second one is you have to create a multi-module system, right, to solve a problem. So in this way, you have to work in group. You need to, okay, follow the system or problem specification, and then you need to create your own software system, right, in C programming that can solve this problem. Okay, this is so what we call course learning outcome. And this is the key of this course. Okay, but now it's 11:24, right? I think I will stop for a while, pause the recording. Okay, now we are talking about the first module, right? The module, I will give you the lecture and also the lab, right, for 5 weeks before I will give you the assessment, right? So the most important thing is that you may have to give me the the real schedule. You have to ask the instructor of the calculus what will be the time for the examination. I think they will have to separate into three or four times of examination. But I need to know that because I want to avoid the time as well. Okay, so for the first module, right, you will have to know about the C language construct, statement, branching, decision making, looping, nesting looping, and then the last topic will be array. And then I will give you an exam. But during that time, right, I will also give you the in-class problem and also the lab topic, right? So you need to finish them, both lab, both problems. I would say that I don't think we will have the paper-based exam. And I think we will not have the formal examination. I will have to give you, I need to you to give me the, okay, I will tell you later about that because we also have, we will have many laboratories, we will have many assignments that you have to finish that in order to get the M1 assessment. And I suggest you all to get A from this M1 assessment. If you have A in your pocket, right, that will be 30%, right? And I hope that you will have the encourage yourself that, oh, I did very well in this course. Mm-hmm. Okay. And this one is M1. And M2, I will teach you structure and union, pointers, function and function parameters, pass by value and pass by reference. And the last one will be the recursion. And then we'll go to the public holiday again. But we have no class on Monday, but we also have the lab on Friday. Okay, that is the end. Okay, the half of October, we have to finish assessment of the second module. And the last one will be the third module, right? I will teach you about how to write the program to access, to read and write the files, both in the text file or the binary format. Right, and then I will teach you about the header files, preprocessors, and macros. Okay, and by that time, right, I will also give you the okay. You will have to work in group of five, and then you have to select a topic that you have to work as your project, the term project. I think I will give you the topic, the term project topic, and then we have 2 weeks for the project presentation, and this will be the scores for your last module, module 3. That is a module 3 for 20%. Okay, and this all for this course. Do you have any question for the grading system and assessment in this course? Okay, I think you